Hello and welcome to Maths by SAS. This is my 15th lesson of D4, chapter number 1, exercise 1A, that is about the linear inequalities in two variables. In this lesson, I will solve advanced level question number 3. And first, let's read the question from the book. Question 3 says, in each of the following cases, write down the inequalities which define unshaded regions. If you read the question carefully, question says that in each of the following cases, write down the inequalities that define unshaded region. If we compare this question with question number 2, we can see that in question, and we can recall that in question number 2, the lines were already given, equation of lines were given, and by looking at the shading in the question, we were turning those equations into inequalities. But if we look at this question, we can see that we are given with the graph, we are given with the shaded and unshaded region, but we are not given with the equation of lines which are defining this unshaded region. And in order to write the inequalities which define the unshaded or shaded region, it's really important first to write the equation of line which defines that region. And in order to write down the equation of any line, we have to recall that how many types of lines are there. We have basically three types of lines, that is horizontal lines, vertical and non-vertical lines, which has the general form y equals to mx plus c or y equals to mx. And I always ask it to my students that before going to the solution of this type of question, you have to identify from the graph and the question given that if there is some horizontal line or vertical line given with the question, try to begin the solution with that, because these two types of lines are comparatively easy. And then recall the method of finding the equation of non-vertical line, y is equal to mx plus c, from coordinate geometry, and always integrate your lesson with the new other lessons, because in this way the learning becomes perfect. Okay, if you look at the C part, we can see that here we have the unshaded region, and this region is bounded by three lines. One of the line is passing through 4 and 3, okay, and the second line is passing through 3 and minus 1, and the third line is passing through 2 and minus 1. In order to find the inequalities which are defining this region, we first have to find the equation of these three lines. So let's begin with the solution. So I will be beginning with equation of line L1. Let the equation of line that passes through 4 and 0 and 4, this point is on x-axis, this is 3 and 0 and 4, let it be L1, and let's go for the calculation of L1. We know that the general form of equation of line is y equals to mx plus c. And now what we have to do, we have to go for the calculation of gradient, and we know that the formula for the gradient is m equals to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. And now if you look at the points given, this is y2, 4 minus 0 upon 0 minus 3, and this gives me minus 4 by 3. Now we have the answer of gradient with us, that m equals to minus 4 by 3. And now we have to go for y equals to mx plus c, and I have to replace m by 4 by 3x and plus c. Now, in order to get value of C, I can pick up any one of the points, and preferably I'm choosing, suppose I'm choosing this point 0 and 4. Over here, instead of y, I will replace 4 equals to minus 4 by 3x, 4 by 3, and x has a value 0 plus c, this vector will become 0, and 4 equals to c, so the equation of line will become y equals to minus 4 by 3x plus 4. Try to make this equation free from fraction, and when I'm making this equation free from fraction, it can take the form, I have to take the LCM, 3y equals to minus 4x plus 12. And now what we have to do is that we can shift this 4x to other side, and equation will take the form, let me move to the top of the page, that 3y plus 4x, 3y plus 4x equals to 12. Now we have found the equation which is passing through the points 0 and 0, 4. Now it's the time to turn this equation into inequality by looking at the shading. Now if we look at the graph which is given in the question, we can see that the shaded region is above this line, shaded region is above this line, and the required region is below the line. So the inequality that will be associated with this line will be 3y plus 4x is less than equal to 12. And let me block this situation. I hope you are clear that how we are finding the equation of line which is passing through two points, and then how we are turning that equation into inequality condition by looking at the shading. Okay, now let's move to the second line, second equation of line. Okay, and let me make some space here so that my students should not mix the working with the other part. Okay, then the second equation of line is equation of the second line. I've done with L1, and now L2 can be, it's your choice, you can pick up any one line and you can find the equation of the line. Suppose I'm finding the equation of line, which is passing through equation of line passing through this is minus 1 and 0, and the second point is 0 with 3 and 0 with 3, let its name be L2. Again, what I have to do, I have to go for y is equal to mx plus c. I have to find the equation of line which passes through two points. So the general form is y is equal to mx plus c, and m equals to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. This is 3 minus 0 upon 0 minus, and minus will become positive. So this will become 3 over 1, which is equal to 3. So the gradient for this line is 3. And now it's the time to find y intercept C. That is 3. Okay, but even then I will be finding it through calculation. That y equals to 3x plus c. Now what I have to do, I can pick up any one of the points from the given points. Suppose I'm picking up this point 0 and 3, so that will give me 3 times 0 plus c equals to 3. This vector will become 0 plus c equals to 3, or 3 equals to c. Now I have m with me, I have c with me. Equation of line will take the form y equals to 3x plus 3. So the equation of line that passes through the point minus 1 and 0, and 0 and 3 is y equals to 3x plus 3. Now focus your attention on the graph. We can see that the shaded region is above this line. Unshaded region, the required region is below the line. So the inequality condition that will be satisfying this equation and this region will be y less than equal to 3x plus 3. I hope you are clear about equation of line L2 and how we are turning that equation into inequality. And let's talk about and think about the equation of line, third line, and what inequality we can write for that equation of line. Okay, now the equation of third line. Now let's move to the third line. Line 1 is done, which is passing through 3 0 and 0 4. Line 2 is done, which is passing through minus 1 0 and 0 3, and now it's a time for the line 3, which is passing through the point 2 0 and 0 minus 1. Again, we have to find y is equal to mx plus c line, and m formula for the m you can take help from coordinate geometry. Y2 minus y1 minus 1 minus 0 upon x2 0 minus 2. Y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1, and m equals to minus 1 by minus 2, or m equals to 1 by 2. Gradient we have calculated, that is 1 by 2. It's a time for value of c, y equals to 1 by 2 x, and plus c. Now pick up any one of the points, and suppose we are taking 0 and minus 1. From the graph, even it's clear that c will be minus 1, but we can go for the calculation as well, and we can check that x value is 0. So it will take the form 1 by 2 into 0 plus c equals to minus 1. Minus 1 equals to 0 multiplied by 1 by 2 will be 0 plus c, and this will give me c equals to minus 1. Now we have the value of m with us, value of c with us. So we have to write the equation of line, y is equal to 1 by 2 x minus 1. Now what we have to do is that we have to turn this fraction and equation of line free from fraction. So we will be taking LCM. So 2y equals to x minus 2. And now the equation will take the form 2y minus x equals to minus 2. And now the, if you look at the graph, we can see that the shaded region is below this line, and if the shaded region is below this line, unshaded region is at the top. So the actual region that and the inequality will be 2y is minus x is greater than equal to minus 2. I hope you are clear about this question, and let's move to the next question. Let's compare the graph with the graph in the book. Okay, let me see. Again, in D part, we are given with the region which is bounded by three lines. One of the line is passing through x value 3 and y value 2. One of the line, the second line, is passing through 2 on y axis and minus 1 on this axis. And the third line is passing through 2 and minus 1. Okay, so let's try to find out first the equations of lines which define this region, and then we will be one by one turning those equations into inequalities. So let's begin with which line. Let's start with the line that is passing through point 3 and 0 and 0 and 2. Equation of line passing through here we have the x value 3, so when any point is on x axis, its y value is 0, 3 and 0, and 0 with 2. We have to find the equation of non-vertical line. We have to find the equation of line in y is equal to mx plus c form. And we know that for the equation of non-vertical line, general equation is y equals to mx plus c. And first we have to find the value of gradient m. Formula for the gradient is, you can take the help from coordinate geometry, y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. y2 minus y1, 2 minus 0, 2 minus 0 upon 0 minus 3, and this gives me 2 minus 0 is 0, and this is 2 by 3 with negative sign, so the gradient is minus 2 by 3. And after getting the gradient, I have to go for the value of c, minus 2 by 3 x and plus c. Now I can take help from any one of the points, and if we look at the graph, we can see this graph has y intercept c2, but even then we can check it. Suppose I'm taking the point 3 and 0. Suppose I'm taking the point 3 and 0 means that y value is 0 and x value is 3, minus 2 by 3 into 3 plus c. This 3 goes with this 3, and I will left with minus 2 plus c. Shift this minus 2 to other side, 2 equals to c. Now we have the value of m with us, we have value of c with us, so the equation of line will be y equals to minus 2 by 3x plus 2. Now what we have to do is that we have to take the LCM and make this equation free from fraction. So this will be 3y, here we have the denominator 1, so when I will be taking the LCM, this is a common error that most of the students commit, 2x plus here we have the denominator 1, 1 times 3 is 3, and when that 3 will be multiplied by 2, this will give me 6, and now go for cross multiplication, and this will give me 3y equals to minus 2x plus 6, or let me move to the top of the page over here. Okay, now 3y plus 2x equals to 6. Now the equation of line which passes through the point 30 and 02 is 3y plus 2x equals to 6. Now the basically why we are finding the equations, we have to find this equation of line to find the inequality which defines this unshaded region. Now look at the graph carefully, we can see that the shading is above this line and the unshaded, the required region, is below the line. So the inequality which will satisfy this region or define the unshaded region will be 3y plus 2x is less than equal to 6. I hope you are clear about this condition, and let's move to the second equation, and then we will be turning that equation into inequality. Okay, now we can take this line is done, and now we can take this equation of line. If we look at the graph carefully, on x-axis this line is passing at 2, and this line on y-axis is meeting at minus 1. So the equation of line which passes through two points, look, over here we have x value 2. When any point is on x axis, its y value is 0, so the point can take the form 2 and 0. And over here we have the value of y minus 1. It can be written as 0 and minus 1. And then we have to go for the calculation of m. Recall the formula for m, that is y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. If the previous concepts are clear, then the new lesson will really be easy. Minus 1 minus 0 upon 0 minus 2. And this can take the form minus 1 by minus 2. This can go, and the gradient for this line is 1 by 2. And now what we have to do, we have to think about C. Here in this graph, for this line, y-intercept C is minus 1, but let's confirm it through calculation as well. So y equals to 1 by 2x plus C. So what we can do is, suppose I'm taking the point 0 and minus 1. Here my y value is minus 1 and x value is 0 plus C. When 0 will be multiplied by 1, this will give me 0 plus C and minus 1, or C equals to minus 1. Now we have M with us, we have C with us, okay. So the equation of line can take the form y equals to 1 by 2x minus 1. Now make your equation free from fraction. So by taking the LCM, it will become 2y equals to x minus 2, or it can be taken in the form 2y minus x equals to minus 2. Now what we have to do is that we have to turn this equation into inequality, which define this unshaded region. Now look carefully that the shading is below this line. Unshaded region is above the line. So the inequality that will define this unshaded region will be 2y minus x is greater than equal to minus 2. I hope you are clear about this condition. And let's talk about the third line. We are done with this line, and we are left with the third line, which is passing through minus 1, x value minus 1 and 0, and y value is 0 with 2. Equation of line passing through what points? X value is minus 1 and 0, and y is 0 with 2. Okay, so first of all we have to find the value of m by using the formula y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1, and this can be taken the form 2 minus 0 upon 0, and minus will become positive, and gradient is 2. After getting the value of gradient, what we have to do, we have to go for the calculation of c. Y equals to 2x plus c. Now I can take any one of the points. Okay, suppose I'm taking, we are looking at this graph, we can see the value of y intercept is 2. I'm taking the point 0 with 2. Y value is 2, and 2 into 0 plus c, and this will become 2 times 0 is 0 plus c. 2 equals to c, or c equals to 2. So the equation of line will be y equals to 2x plus 2. Now after getting the equation of line, what we have to do, we have to look at the diagram. We can see that the shading is above this line. Unshaded region is below this line. So in order to write down the inequality which define this unshaded region, will be y is less than equal to y is less than equal to 2x plus 2. I hope you are clear about today's lesson. For next difficulty level, please you have to watch and understand this lesson carefully so that the next lesson will become easy for you. For better understanding of this lesson, you should have the good command on the three types of lines: horizontal, vertical and non-vertical lines, and how to calculate equation of non-vertical line when two points are given. You can take the help from the coordinate geometry. That will be helping you. Always integrate your lesson with the other lessons so that learning become perfect. Please watch my lessons, like, share and subscribe the channel, and press bell icon to get the notification of every lesson in time. Thank you very much.